Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates. Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I am driving this, the Audi A4, and straight away let's open the engine bay of this vehicle. Now this happens to be the 35 TDI because it is powered by a diesel engine, hydraulic struts, insulation right there, TDI badging there. Engine bay is compact, everything is well packaged, looks brilliant, doesn't it? Of course it does. And as you can see at the front, there's some sort of TT elements on the design of this vehicle, which definitely looks nice. The grille is bigger and it kind of gives it the wide look. Definitely the car looks very sharp, very understated, and of course very elegant as well. Towing hook, headlamp washer, front parking sensors, the lights are really very nice. They're very sharp, DRLs look beautiful, and of course they are all LEDs too. The A4 certainly looks the part. It's so understated, it is so freaking elegant. The alloy wheels might not be too glamorous, I would say. And the tire size happens to be 225 50 17s. Disc is big in size, lot of brake dust as well, Pirelli rubber. And here, as you can see from the side, the length isn't that much, but somehow this car is just so understated, just so elegant, just looks so mind-bogglingly beautiful to me, of course. But at the rear, again, you can see very sharp, nice, and of course subtle elements. In fact, it gets dual exhaust here, which means that it is a diesel, the petrol one gets one. Rear parking sensors, reverse parking camera, Audi logo there. The tail light is also very beautiful, certainly looks very nice in the night. Meanwhile, there's a Sharkwave antenna there, and as I circle around the car, it just reminds me that a sedan doesn't necessarily need to be flashy, it just can look beautiful as it is. So any which ways, you can see here the mirror is attached to the body, the door rather, not to the A-pillar. Again, gives it that sporty look, and of course it gets the indicator here. Meanwhile, another party trick of this car is of course the indicators, which means I need to turn them on right away. And as you can see at the front, they are the regular indicators, right? But at the rear, it gets dynamic swipe indicators. Yup, it swipes from inside to the outside, 35 TDI badging there. Let's open the 480 liter boot, and there it is. The boot is a decent size, of course, and you can increase the boot carrying capacity because there's a 40-20-40 split, which just increases carrying capacity. Okay, net here as well. I think this happens to be some sort of the toolkit as well as the first aid box. And below here, you can see there's a spare wheel, which isn't an alloy, which is a smaller size tire. Yeah, for temporary use, obviously, it cannot accommodate the big fat tire of this vehicle. So it says maximum 80 kilometers per hour. The tire size is 125 70 19. Yeah, it is a weird tire size, but you know, you can clip it like this to keep it holded and easily remove the spare wheel too. Okay, let's quickly get into the rear seat, but before that, you can see the warning triangle can be removed from there. Now the door handles are also very sweet. Okay, they come up like that. Yep, that's how they come. You can see the chrome lining here, again very beautiful, very understated. The doors are so light, the whole car feels so light, they have lost weight. All right, beige treatment, wood treatment, chrome treatment, you name it, everything is there. Door pockets are decent size as well. The rear seat is a bit pushed back and low, which helps increase the leg room as well as knee room of the vehicle. You can see there's good amount of leg room and knee room on offer. Scooped out seat back, magazine holder, and here you get an ashtray along with a cigarette lighter. Air conditioning controls at the rear. Yep, it gets a 3-zone climate control system. AC vents are placed here, none on the pillars here. Yeah, but still there's good amount of cooling in this vehicle. Headroom is decent too. There's a hook here, there's a handle here, there's a hook here, there's a handle here. They're light placed here. It gets 3 headrests at the rear, which is of no use because you can see the hump here. The car is just not wide enough for 3 passengers at the rear along with the hump. I mean, it's just a 2-seater. Still, they have given it an adjustable headrest in the center. There's a center armrest here as well, which opens, and yeah, you know, you can keep stuff here. Meanwhile, there are twin cup holders here. Yeah, that is how they open. So plenty of practical bits inside this vehicle. And the rear seat obviously gets this sun visor, which has to be manually used, blocks the sun, is quite effective. Let's quickly get into the driver's seat because there's a lot of action happening there. First and foremost, this car doesn't get passive entry, so you just can't put your hand inside and be like, okay, the door will open. You have to open it with the key. Door pockets are decent size at the front. This is to open the boot. These are the power window controls. These are the mirror controls. This is obviously to lock or unlock the vehicle. The front seats get power adjustment. Yep, power adjusted electric adjust seats, and you can adjust it in a lot of ways. The driver's seat gets memory settings. You can save up to 2 people settings. You can see the pedals are also big enough, and obviously it gets a large dead pedal too. You know what? This storage space is really very deep. Okay, see my hand when I take it inside. Yep, that's how deep it is. I think this is to keep the manual of the vehicle because it's big enough. Meanwhile, obviously, it gets automatic headlights, it gets automatic wipers. This is to increase or decrease the intensity of the cluster. Meanwhile, this is for front fog light, this is for rear fog light, and obviously, these are the controls for the headlights. Let's quickly get inside. The car is a little low, I wouldn't deny that, but I cannot deny the fact that in spite of the car being low, it certainly has a very comfortable seat. The seats are very comfortable everywhere. Whether you're big or small, you'll be comfortable inside the car. Okay, let's turn on the vehicle, which means pressing the start engine stop button. There it rose to life. Steering is light. It's quite big as such. These are the controls for the navigation, voice commands, as well as the volume. These are the controls for this virtual cockpit display. And this display is so freaking awesome. You can browse through a lot of things here too. Look at that map. It's so freaking amazing. This is one of the best displays in the segment without a doubt. And you can browse through the multi-information display. It's in consumption 8.4 kilometers per liter. And you can see a lot of data here as well. I mean, you don't need to look here at all. Everything is there in this beautiful cluster. The horn is decent too. These are the controls for the wipers. Let's use them right away. Good amount of spray. Dual blade wipers do a great job of cleaning the windscreen. You can see the windscreen is absolutely clean. You can never ever think even a drop of water fell there 5 seconds back. This torque is obviously the control for the indicator. It gets cruise control too. This is the control for the cruise control. Meanwhile, the steering is adjustable for both reach as well as rake. It has to. Over here, we get a 7-inch infotainment screen. It's not a touchscreen, unfortunately. These are the controls for the air conditioning. So if I turn them on, you can see it says 3-zone. Beautiful treatment. Let's look at the treatment on the knobs, and it tells you the temperature inset. Air conditioning works brilliantly well on this car, and you know what the best thing is, that they've taken a lot from the flagship Q7. So this continuous vent running treatment is from the Q7. Even the galley is from the Q7. Feels really nice to hold. Glove box is decent size. There's a big fat manual. In fact, the manual is so fat, takes me 3 years to just read that. Meanwhile, here you can see there's a CD slot, there are two SD slots and a SIM slot as well. Quality levels are really nice. You can see there's wood in the center, and Audi has done a great job using very premium materials. In fact, the inside rear view mirror, which is auto dimming, gets a frameless treatment, and here you obviously get a mirror along with a light. The light is LED. Everywhere there's LED inside the car. That's so beautiful. Lot of lights here. To use them, all you have to do is press this button. There, the lights are so freaking amazing. It obviously gets a sunroof, and it is a decent sized sunroof. It gets a one-piece sunroof. Pressing it again won't help because that's the maximum it opens still, and you can push it behind manually a bit. Yeah, it brings in the airy feeling, but the cabin is already very airy thanks to the fact that it gets a lot of beige. It's not really beige, it's, I think, grayish. Combination of gray and beige. Looks really nice. In fact, here you get a 12-volt charging socket, twin cup holders, and you get a lot of controls. These are obviously the controls for the MMI. There is this 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 8 pad. Meanwhile, you know, you can get into radio, media, navigation, and telephone from here itself. It is just so freaking awesome the way this system works, because, I mean, obviously, one thing is browsing like this, and secondly, it also gets this touch-sensitive controls, which, you know, actually feel very nice. It makes this noise, it tells you exactly what is happening. Getting into car, you can decide what mode you want to drive the car: comfort, auto, dynamic, individual. And you know what? There's this button here. You can press this button as well to use it. This is to turn off traction control. This is to turn on and off the parking sensors, and this is to turn off the screen. Now the screen is fixed. Okay, it doesn't retract and get inside. That doesn't happen here. There's a slot here specifically to keep the key. Yeah, that is the key slot. This is the volume control, or to go to next or previous track. And this is the auto hold function. This is the electric parking brake. This is the gear lever. Okay, a lot of sweat right now, I'm so sorry about that. Okay, this is the gear lever. Feels really nice to hold. And below the front center armrest, this storage space as well, the two USB ports along with an aux port. There's a cigarette lighter here too, and of course there is a wireless charging pad. Okay, these are the keys of my motorcycle, Motorbeam keychain there. Okay, let's use the wireless charger right away, which means that I just need to keep it here. Oh my god, this BMW, what is happening? So here, and there it starts charging right away. Yeah, there it starts charging right away. So as you can see, cabin is really nice, well laid out, and there's good amount of headroom on offer. There's a handle here also on the driver's side. There's a handle there as well. Plenty of airbags inside this car. And small touches which make this vehicle feel so premium is something which Audi has done greatly well in this vehicle. Of course, I love everything about this car, especially how understated and elegant it is. Let's quickly connect the phone to listen to an audio right away. Baby, we don't need no reason. Audio quality is really very nice. In fact, the attention to detail here is massive. Okay, you can see there's a digital speedometer inset, the analog speedometer, and there's an analog tachometer as well, but everything is actually digital because that's a digital screen. And on the corner, you obviously get the fuel meter as well as the temperature meter. Everything feels so nice and premium inside this vehicle. Great job, Audi. Great job to give that premium appeal. And it just makes it feel like a class above. That's the level of quality inside the cabin, the design, everything feels really nice. But how is it to drive? Well, let's get going right away. All right, we're all set to go, which means turning off the air conditioning, turning off traction control, getting into drive mode. But before that, let's get into reverse. This is the reverse parking camera. It gets adaptive guidelines as well. Okay, now we are into drive mode, getting the drive select into dynamic mode. Right now we are in dynamic, which means automatically the gearbox in sport mode. Yeah, it is in sport mode, and traction control is off. Left foot on the brake, right foot on the accelerator, revving the motor. Rev still around 2000 RPM, and yeah, it bogged down somehow. I don't know why it keeps bogging down, but a proper launch would happen like this. Yep, and we are off. As you can see, performance is great. It's very slick. This 2-liter diesel engine produces 188 horsepower and 400 newton meters of torque, which comes in between 1750 to 2500 RPM. In fact, there's good amount of low-end punch. Turbo lag is well contained, so well contained that drivability is great, and it feels very punchy and lively even in the low end. But it's really the mid-range which shines in this car, because the mid-range feels very nice and punchy, and there's a proper kick in the pants feel as well in the mid-range. It really takes off. It has a top end too, because it's going to rev all the way to almost 4800 RPM. So yes, the motor is smooth, it's refined, doesn't feel like a diesel at all, and revs very quickly as well. There's good amount of punch on offer. 0 to 100 kilometers per hour takes just 8 seconds, and the top speed is 237 kilometers per hour. In fact, this motor is so lively that it does triple digit speeds in a flash, making an overtake out on the highway no issue at all. Just get into the gas and it will do it in no time, because there is just so much grunt on offer. This motor is very lively, very punchy, and absolutely fab, very refined too. It doesn't feel like a diesel at all. That is the level of smoothness on offer. What an engine, Audi, what an engine. Unfortunately, the petrol engine isn't much to talk about, because that 1.4 liter is down on displacement, produces just 150 horsepower. And although it is decently quick, because this is a light car, Audi has actually reduced the weight of this vehicle by around 100 kgs. It uses the MLB Evo platform, which is shared with other Audis as well. It doesn't use the MQB. The MLB is a more advanced platform, and it just feels so light and agile. In fact, the weight of this vehicle might be 1600 kgs. You can't feel anything at all. The way this car drives, or actually the way it is so easy to maneuver, it actually feels like a compact sedan. Yeah, it does torque steer, and that is because it's a front wheel drive car in a segment where most of the rivals are actually rear wheel drive. And actually, it's the front wheel drive layout which, you know, makes it so light and agile as well. There is some amount of understeer on the limit, but it doesn't oversteer like its rival, so that fun factor is missing here. Overall ride quality is absolutely brilliant. It runs on low profile rubber. Yeah, 50 is the profile of the tires, but it just feels so freaking composed over the worst of roads. Trust me, Audi has done a great job and given it leaps and bounds improvement in terms of ride quality, because it just feels so composed even on the worst of roads. Even bad potholes don't rattle the car at all. Such is the level of ride quality. And you know, it doesn't have that inherent stiffness which is expected of a German car. It just feels perfect. The suspension setup is just right. It doesn't feel stiff, it doesn't feel soft. It's right in the center, which gives it great composure. Even at high speeds, it remains glued to the road. Yes, there's some amount of vertical movement at high speeds over bad roads, but for the most part, the ride quality is absolutely brilliant. There are 4 driving modes on offer. There's auto, there's individual, there is comfort, and there is dynamic. Right now we are driving in dynamic mode. It only alters 2 parameters, the engine and the steering wheel. Actually, the engine, gearbox in one combo, and the steering wheel. It makes the steering feel a little heavier, giving it more heft, but still the steering isn't the best in terms of feel, especially when you compare it to its rivals. Both the 3 series and the C-Class just offer more feel and feedback from the steering. However, this steering is also quite direct. It inspires confidence to push hard and fast, and body roll is very well contained. This car does go through the corners with a lot of confidence. Yeah, this car loves to spin its wheels, because there's so much low-end grunt and obviously good amount of torque on offer as well. So obviously this Audi is a great car. Braking performance is also very strong, very sure-footed. Everything feels well put together, and this 7-speed dual clutch gearbox is absolutely super fast with shifts. Not only does it give you quick shifts, it just feels so responsive. You want a downshift, it will do it. However, it will not give you any manual control of things. Now, obviously, you can slot the gear lever to the left to get into manual mode, or you can push it back once again to get into sport mode. Right now it's in sport mode, or you can touch the paddles to obviously get into manual mode. But even in manual mode, it will not hold on to a gear, it will just upshift. So there is no manual control. However, the gearbox is so fast that even when you're shifting manually, you will not crib when the gearbox takes over, because it is just so freaking quick with shifts. And this car is so fuel efficient that Audi is so confident it has not even given it an eco mode. Yes, there's no eco mode on offer. However, ARAI rated fuel economy is a stellar 18.25 kilometers per liter. In the real world, it will return between 14 to 15 kilometers per liter, which again is fab. Now, all of this fab thing about this Audi is mainly because of the lightweight of this car. And this lightweight gives it better agility, better maneuverability, and even makes it feel like a much smaller car to drive, which is actually a great thing because it doesn't intimidate you. It inspires you to push harder and faster around the corners. Although in terms of handling, it is not in the same league as its German rivals. That said, it is just neutral, and that neutralness is something which is worth appreciating. This car obviously rides better than its rivals, and not only that, it also has more space than its rivals, making it a very practical purchase in the segment. And talking about purchase, there are 5 variants on offer: 2 for the diesel, 3 for the petrol. The petrol is also available in some special edition. The trim levels are premium plus and technology. And this top of the line technology diesel variant is priced at Rs 57.15 lakhs on road Mumbai. Yes, it might look on the expensive side, but this is a very well-rounded off car. Want to save some money? You can opt for the lower trims. The price range starts at Rs 50 lakhs for the Audi A4. Find me a car in this segment which spins its wheels like this and doesn't scare you silly. Well, this is the Audi A4 for you. In fact, the motor revs really very fast. For a turbo motor, you don't feel any lag whatsoever. That is the level of performance on offer, and it goes through the red line in a rush. It is so fast revving. It's an absolute fab motor. In fact, I can't really pinpoint any issues with this car other than the fact that it is front wheel drive. Because yeah, it gives a little bit understeery characteristic, not an oversteery characteristic. And oversteer is obviously more fun in any car, especially if it's a German car. So guys, this is my review of the Audi A4, a fab vehicle. And for me, it is personally Audi's entry-level car for India, not the A3. The A3 just feels too Skoda-ish with the MQB platform. However, the A4 feels like a genuine Audi and genuinely a very fun, practical, and even value for money car in the segment. And if you like this video, you know what you have to do. Give it a thumbs up. That's a like button. And also subscribe to the channel. I will see you guys in the next video real soon. Dhanil, what happened? Honda to Audi, what's happening, man?
Give it a thumbs up.
Done. Bye-bye.